गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ क्लास ट्वेल्थ मैथ्स लेक्चर सेकेंड ऑफ चैप्टर एट्थ एप्लीकेशन ऑफ इंटीग्रल्स. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द क्वेश्चंस ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 8.1. सो क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट इज फाइंड द एरिया ऑफ द रीजन बाउंडेड बाय द कर्व वाई स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू एक्स एंड द लाइन्स एक्स इक्वल टू 1 एंड एक्स इक्वल टू 4 एंड द एक्स एक्सिस. दैट इज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल मेक द ग्राफ. सो दिस इज द ग्राफ ऑफ वाई स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू एक्स. यू कैन ऑल्सो टेक द पॉइंट्स टू प्लॉट दिस ग्राफ, राइट. This is the line x equal to 1, this is the line x equal to 4 and this is x axis. So we have to find this area which is bounded by the curve, these lines and the x axis. So to find it, we will find the integral of y into dx, where y is nothing but root x, right, and the limits are from 1 to 4, right, because we are taking the limits of x axis. So the function will be in the terms of x only, because from the limits 1 to 4 the function is below this curve. So this curve in terms of x is root x, right. Now solve the integral, which is x raised to the power 3 by 2 upon 3 by 2 and the limits are from 1 to 4. Now put the limits, first put the upper limit, so you'll get 8 minus, now put the lower limit, so when you will put 1 raised to the power 3 by 2 is 1, so you'll get the answer as 14 by 3. Question number second is find the area of the region bounded by the curve y square is equal to 9x, x is equal to 2, x is equal to 4 and the x axis in the first quadrant. That is, we have to find the area bounded by this curve y square is equal to 9x, the line x equal to 2 and x equal to 4 and the x axis in the first quadrant. So this is the region, right. Now the area of this region will be integral of 3 into root x into dx from the limits 2 to 4, right. The limits are from 2 to 4 and the region is below the curve, this y square equal to 9x. So find the value of y in terms of x, it will be plus minus 3 into root x. But in the first quadrant you can see y is positive, therefore we will take 3 into root x. Now solve the integral, x raised to the power 3 by 2 upon 3 by 2 is the integral of root x. Limits are from 2 to 4. Now put the limits, you'll get the answer as 16 minus 4 root 2. Now question number 5th is find the area of the region bounded by the ellipse x square by 4 plus y square by 9 equal to 1. Now see, to draw the graph of this ellipse, compare it with the standard equation of the ellipse. So you will get the value of a as 2 and the value of b as 3. Now draw the graph of this ellipse. It will cut the x axis at minus 2 and 2 and the y axis at 3 and minus 3, right. So this is the graph of the ellipse. Now we have to find the area bounded by this complete ellipse, because ellipse is symmetrical about y axis also and about x axis also, therefore we will just find the area of this shaded region and then multiply it with 4 to get the total area. So it will be equal to 4 into area of region OABO, right. Now see, to find the area of this region, either you can take the limits from the x axis, that is from 0 to 2, or from the y axis, that is the limits from 0 to 3, right. I have taken the limits of the x axis, that is from 0 to 2. Now the function will be taken in terms of x, so you will get it as 3 by 2 into root 4 minus x square. Why? See, because when you will find the value of y in terms of x, it will be this. Now from both of these terms take out 9 common, and from the root 9 is 3, so 3 by 2 root 4 minus x square. Also we will take the positive value y, because y is positive here in the first quadrant. Now solve it, this will be 6. Integral of root 4 minus x square is x by 2 root 4 minus x square plus a square upon 2 into sine inverse x upon a. A here is 2 and the limits are from 0 to 2. Now put the limits. First in place of x, put 2. So you will get 6 in 2. Now when you will put 2 here, this will become 0. Plus 4 by 2 in 2, this will be sine inverse 1, which is pi by 2. Minus, when in place of x you will put 0, both of these terms will be 0. So you will get the answer as 6 pi. Question number 7 is, find the area of the smaller part of the circle x square plus y square equal to a square cut off by the line x equal to a upon root 2. So this is the circle given. So draw the circle, right? And this is the line given, x equal to a by root 2. Now this is the point A. Obviously a by root 2 will be smaller than a. So let a by root 2 be here. Now draw this line, x equal to a upon root 2. They have asked to find the region of the smaller part. Now this is the smaller part. So we have to find this region, right? You can also find these points. These points are the intersection of the circle and the line. So in place of x square, put this a square by 2. So you'll get the value of y as plus minus a upon root 2. So this is the point a upon root 2 and a upon root 2. And this is the point when x is a upon root 2 and y is minus a upon root 2, right? It is not required to find this if you are doing this question by taking the limits of the x-axis. It will be required if you find the area by using the limits of the y-axis. Now I am using the limits of the x-axis. Now see, because the circle is symmetrical about y-axis, so this complete portion is twice of the area of the region ABPA, right, of this region. So the area of this region will be root a by 2 to a integral of y into dx, and y here will be the circle, because you can see this region from a root 2, a upon root 2 to a, this region lies below the circle. So we will take the function of the circle, which is root a square minus x square. Now solve this integral and put the limits, right? So rest of the part you have to do by yourself. Now the next question is, if we have to find the area bounded by the circle x square plus y square equal to 32, the line y equal to x and the x axis. So this is the circle x square plus y square equal to 32. This is the line y equal to x and this is the x axis. So this is the region which we want to find, right? Now also find the point of intersection of the circle and the line. For this, in place of this y, I am writing x. So y square will be x square. So this will become 2x square equal to 32. So x will be plus minus 4. Because here x will be positive, so this point will be 4 comma 4. Because when x is 4, here, y will also be 4, right? So the limits are from 0 to 4 by root 2, and we have to find this region. But you can see from the limit 0 to 4, area lies below the line. So from the limit 0 to 4, we will take integral of the function of x, that is the function of the line, plus from the limits 4 to 4 root 2, area lies below the circle. So we will take the function of the circle now. So the function of circle in terms of x will be root 32 minus x square. Now solve this integral and this integral and put the limits. You'll get the answer. In this question, we have to find the area bounded by the ellipse x square upon a square plus y square upon b square equal to 1 and the line x equal to 0 and x equal to ae, where this b square is given as a square into 1 minus e square. So this is a square minus a square into e square. Therefore, b square will be less than a square, because b square is equal to a square minus something. So b square will be less than a square. So the major axis of this ellipse will be the x-axis, right? So the ellipse will be like this. And because e is less than 1, given in the question, if e is less than 1, then ae will be less than a, right? So the line x equal to ae, because ae is less than a, so here it will be on the left side of a, right? Now this is the line x equal to ae and this is the line x equal to 0. So we have to find this bounded region. And this bounded region is twice of the area of OPQRO, right? Because ellipse is symmetrical about x-axis, therefore area of this complete will be area of twice of area of this region. Now area of this region will be, if I will take the limits from the x-axis, so twice into integral of b by a root a square minus x square into dx, and the limits are from 0 to a. Now solve this integral, taking constant common, so you'll get 2b by a integral of root a square minus x square is x by 2 root a square minus x square plus a square upon 2 sine inverse x by a, and the limits are from 0 to a. Now put these limits. So when you will put x in ae in place of x, you will get ae upon 2 root a square minus in place of x a square e square plus a square upon 2. Here when you will place ae in place of x, so you will get sine inverse e. Now minus, put 0 in place of x, so this term will become 0, and also this sine inverse 0 is also 0, right? So after solving, you will get this as the answer, ab into e root 1 minus e square plus sine inverse e, right? Question number 9th of exercise 8.1 is, find the area of the region bounded by the parabola y is equal to x square and y is equal to modulus of x. So we will draw the graph of y is equal to x square, which is this. If you do not know, take the points and plot it, right? And the graph of this y is equal to modulus x will be this V-shaped graph, right? Now we have to find the area which is bounded by y is equal to x square and this. So the area will be this portion plus this portion, right? So we will find the area of any of these portion and multiply it with 2 to get the complete area. Now see, we will find the area of the region OAO and multiply it with 2 to get the complete area. So the limits to find the area of this region is from 0 to 1, right? Now to find the area between the curve y is equal to x square and this line, first of all find the area between the line and the x-axis from the limit 0 to 1, which can be done as integral of x from the limit 0 to 1. And now find the area of the curve and the x-axis from the limit 0 to 1. So it will be this area. Now when you will subtract this area from this complete area, so you will get this portion only, right? Therefore we will subtract from this integral of x square from the limit 0 to 1. Now integral of x is x square by 2 minus integral of x square is x cube by 3, and the limits are from 0 to 1. When you will put the limits, you will get the answer as 1 by 3, right? So if we have to find the area between a curve and a line, then first of all find the area of the curve which lies above. So in this you can see the line lies above the parabola. So find the area of the line with the x-axis, right? And from it subtract the area which lies, area of the curve which lies below. So here parabola lies below the line, so find the area of the parabola with the x-axis and subtract it from this area, then you will get the area which is required, right? Your today's homework is do question 8 to 13th of exercise 8.1, okay?